So PFASs are a huge group of chemicals that are found in almost everywhere.
Megan Arnett is the executive director for the UC Berkeley Center for Green Chemistry and has been knee-deep in one particular chemical.
They are polyfluoroalkyls.
PFAS became popular in the 1940s, famously in those nonstick pans you may have inside your house.
But from that, a huge industry grew because they are very effective at what they do. They are very good at creating moisture barriers, which is something that we need in our daily lives.
So effective are they at stopping moisture from seeping through things, you can find PFAS in everything, from rugs to the chair you may be sitting on to tablecloths. And even
the example that I often use is think about your butter wrappers for the butter that's in your refrigerator. You want that to have a strong moisture barrier, right? You don't want things to be leaching in or out of that wrapper.
But over time, studies of PFAS have shown that exposure can lead to major health risks. It's what they call an endocrine disrupting chemical, disrupting the hormones in your body. And people exposed to large amounts of it, like firefighters, who have a higher risk of exposure to lots of chemicals, have higher rates of cancer.
We're really just starting to understand, and it is very hard to make these conclusive statements because we are exposed to a lot of chemicals in our daily life.
Other cancers can be caused from high exposure as well, like breast, ovarian, and skin cancer.
Even like cosmetic products that have PFAS in them, there are feminine hygiene products that have PFAS in them, but we are moving away from that.
And with awareness comes more alternatives. Mike Cherry, KCRA3, investigates.
Now, there are resources to find products without these forever chemicals, and we'll post those on our website and on the KCRA3 app. And coming up tonight at 10, that forever chemical, PFAS, is also causing higher rates of cancer in firefighters, as was mentioned in the story. Mike's investigation looks into the dangers for firefighters that they don't even see but are exposed to every time they go out to fight a fire.